Hey all, in this video we're going to go over the quiz 1 study guide answers. So if you just want to quickly check your answers, just look at the answer key that's posted, but this video is going to provide you some explanations. All right, so the first question on the study guide had a set of 10 graphs. 5 of them are shown here, and we're going to just talk about the motion that's going on in each of these graphs, and then on the next slide I'll go over the other 5. All right, so first up, let's talk about the types of graphs we're looking at. Now all 5 of these are the same. They're all position graphs. And you can determine that by these X's that are up in the top corner. That just stands for position, okay? So when you see an X in the corner, it's a position graph. All right, so this first graph, we have a position graph. We have a diagonal line that's headed, a curved line that's headed up on the graph. So if it's headed up, then it's moving in the positive for forward direction. So I'm just gonna put a plus sign for positive direction. And we have this curved line here. So a curved line means we are accelerating. And if it's getting steeper at the end, like this one is, it's flatter down here and steeper over here, that means it's speeding up. So I'm just going to do an up arrow for speeding up. Right? For this second graph, we again have a position graph. We have a diagonal line headed towards our, in the negative direction, it's going down. So that means it's headed in the backwards or negative direction. So I'm going to put a negative sign to tell you that. We have a diagonal line, so that tells us we have constant velocity. All right. The third graph, we have a horizontal line. So a horizontal line means we are not moving. All right, it just means that object is sitting at that location the whole time. All right, the fourth one down here, we have a curved line headed up on the graph. So if it's headed up, it's a positive direction or forwards. And then this one is getting flatter towards the end. It's much flatter here than it was here. All right, so that means it's slowing down. And slowing down is a type of acceleration. So it is accelerating. And it is slowing down, right? And then this last graph, you're like, I've never seen a vertical line like that. And that's because they don't exist. This graph is here just to trick you. Just like you could see on like an ACT or SAT test, there's always an answer choice there to throw you off that like is a fake answer. This one's a fake answer. You'll never see that vertical line, okay? Next 5 graphs. These are varying more. So we have some that are position, some velocity, and some acceleration. Velocities will have a V. Accelerations will have an A, all right? So this first one, we have a position graph. We have a diagonal line. So diagonal line tells us constant velocity. And the diagonal line's headed up on the graph, so that's the positive or forwards direction, right? The second one here, we also have a diagonal line. They look the same, except for this is a velocity graph, right? So velocity graph, to determine if it's going forwards or backwards, we need to know if we're above or below the x-axis. So in this case, we're clearly above our x-axis, so that is going in the positive direction. But with a diagonal line on a velocity graph, it does not mean constant velocity like this one. It is something different. It means that we have acceleration. So we're positive direction, we're accelerating, and our line is going away from zero. So it is speeding up, okay? If it's starting at zero and going up, then it's speeding up. All right, the next one, we have an acceleration graph and we have a diagonal line on it. And we've never talked about these. This is another graph that's just there to throw you off. It's not a possible graph, all right? So if you see this on a quiz or a test, immediately just cross it out. You will not have a diagonal line on an acceleration graph, okay? It's just there to throw you off. All right, this fourth one down here, we have a velocity graph designated by the V here. We have a horizontal line, rather, above our x-axis. So if we're above the x-axis on a velocity graph, we are moving in the positive direction, okay? We have a horizontal line, and a horizontal line on a velocity graph means constant velocity, right? And then the last one, we have an acceleration graph. We don't actually get a lot of information out of acceleration graphs. What we can tell from this one is we have a positive acceleration. We actually don't know enough to say if it's going forwards or backwards or speeding up and slowing down. We only know positive acceleration. That is it. Okay? So if you're having trouble with determining the motion of these graphs like this, I highly recommend just keep rereading through your notes and keep studying, or reach out to me and ask me questions about and tell me what you're not getting to help you, okay? All right, moving on to question 2. In this graph, we're looking at which segments does the object have the following motion, okay? And this is a position time graph. It's labeled distance time graph, but that's the same thing as a position graph. So we're just gonna label A, B, C, and D since we don't have any numbers on our graph, right? So when it's moving forwards on a position graph, when is it moving forwards is when your line is headed up on the graph. So in sections A and B is when it's headed up on the graph, okay? For moving backwards or the negative direction is when it's headed down on the graph, or C and D is when it's headed down on the graph. Right? For not moving, you're looking for a horizontal line. And on here, this graph, you never have a horizontal line. So it's never not moving. All right. Then for deaccelerating, accelerating means you're speeding up or slowing down. It encompasses both of those things. So you're, and with a position graph, you're looking for curved lines. Curved lines tell you you're accelerating. So it'd be A, B, and C. Okay. Because those are all curves. Then moving with a constant velocity means you're going to have a diagonal line, and it could be headed up on the graph or down on the graph for as long as it's a diagonal. And that would be D is the one that's doing that. Okay. All right. Moving on to our velocity time graph for the number three, during which time segments does the object have the falling motion? All right. Moving forward. So a velocity graph moving forward is when your line is above the x-axis. So be careful of your numbers down here. They go, by one, every three blocks it goes up by one. So for moving forward, starts at 2 to the end. So 2 to 5 seconds is moving forwards. That's the entire time it's above your x-axis. Moving backwards, it's got to be below your x-axis. So from 0 to 2 is below. All right, accelerating. Accelerating on a velocity graph means you have a diagonal line. So anywhere there's a diagonal. So from 0 to 1, we have a diagonal. From 1 all the way to 3, from 4 to 5. So you can say 0 to 3 and then 4 to 5. Right? Anywhere there's a diagonal is accelerating. All right. So then number 4, we want to determine the acceleration for the following times. So to do that, you're finding slope. All right. Now, if you miss these questions and you're good at finding slope, you probably just miss the numbers. Make sure you're not counting boxes and you're actually using the numbers at the bottom on the axes, okay? So from 0 to 1 second, you're starting at 0, you're going to 1, your rise goes to -6, and then your run goes from 0 over to 1. So -6 divided by 1 is just -6, all right? And then your units for acceleration are meters per second squared. And then 1 to 3 seconds, it does not matter that this crosses the x-axis. What it matters that it can, it's just continuous, all right? It keeps the same slope the whole time. It does not matter that it crosses the x-axis. So we're gonna figure out the rise here. It goes from -6 up to +6. So that's a +12 that it goes up. And it goes from 1 to 3, so that's 2 seconds. So 12 divided by 2 is a +6. So your slope there is 6 meters per second squared. Okay. And then for number 5, we're looking for how far has the object moved between 0 and 1 seconds, and then 3 to 4. So with that, from 0 to 1, we want to find that area between our line and our x-axis. So we're going to get a triangle out of that. So it'd be 1/2. And then our height of our triangle is -6. Its width is 1. Again, don't count the boxes. Look at the numbers on the axis. All right. So that is going to equal -3. So this object went -3 meters during that 1 second, okay? For B, 3 to 4 seconds, we are finding a rectangle here. We're going from our line to our x-axis, and then we're gonna use the rectangle formula. Again, don't count boxes, use the numbers on the axis. So our height of our box is 6, and our width here from 3 to 4 is just 1 second. So its area is 6 meters, so that object traveled 6 meters during those that 1 second, okay? Right, let's go over the last bit, and this has been on almost every like worksheet or practice thing we've done, or the additional practice on your notes. So number 6, the blank of the line on a position time graph, that's XT is position time graph, tells you the velocity of the object at a time, and that is the slope on a position graph tells you that. Number 7, the slope of the line on a velocity time graph tells you the acceleration. All right, I'm going to abbreviate acceleration. Number 8, the blank between the line and the x-axis on a velocity time graph will tell you the displacement of the object, and that would be area. All right, the area between the line and the x-axis on acceleration graph will tell you the velocity. All right, and I haven't shown you this yet before, but normally about halfway through the unit, I'll make this list for you. So we have the three graphs, position time, velocity time, and acceleration time graphs. If you're going down the list when it's written in this order, if you're going down the list, you're going to use slope to find the next thing on the list. And you can't skip over, like we can't go from position to acceleration. We've got to go one at a time. And if you're going up the list, you're going to use area. And again, you can't go, you can't skip over. So that takes all of these four sentences and puts it in one little shortcut. So if you have a position graph and you want to find velocity, you use slope. If you have a velocity graph and you want to find acceleration, you find slope. If you have a velocity graph and you want to find how far it went, you use area. If you have an acceleration graph and you want to find velocity, you use the area. Okay, so I hope that kind of helps a little bit. And I'll bring this back up again later in the unit. But anyway, if you still have any questions, please reach out to me. I'll be happy to answer them, okay?